Hi, and welcome back to HP How To For You. I'm Steph, and this is Bill, and we are both employees in the customer support organization.
Every 2 weeks, we're going to bring you tips, tricks, and how-to information on how to use your PC a little bit more efficiently. In our second episode, we're going to talk about PC startup.
Yes, so let's get started. In our last episode, we talked about the Windows 10 release, some of the new features, and how to get around. We also talked a bit about the audits we were conducting on new Windows 10 PCs at the factory. So today, we are going to share some of those tips on how to best set up your new PC for the first time. These are some of the same steps that Bill uses in auditing to make sure the PC is running correctly. We're going to share those with you today so you can do the same.
Yep, so you bring home your new PC. It's nice, bright, and shiny. You take it out of the box. You plug in the keyboard, the mouse, power. If it's a tower like this, you'd plug in your monitor, but this is an all-in-one. And those are the things you plug in, nothing else. You power it on, and you go through the out-of-box experience, or UBI.
UBI!
UBI.
UBI!
And what you do during UBI is just set the PC up. You're going to accept all the license agreements. You're going to give it a computer name. You're going to do a lot of the things that are on the screen right now. So we're just going to go through this real quick. Now you're at the selection for region and language, and we're going to go ahead and select next here. This will apply those settings. The next one that will pop up on screen is the license agreement. We have the Microsoft, the HP, and the McAfee license agreements. Then you'll get to the register screen, and we'll click here for your name, and we'll register this one as How To. Go ahead and click next. Then we'll get to the PC name, and we'll call this one an all-in-one. And then it'll detect any networks we might have. We'll go ahead and skip that step and use our express settings and put in a username.
It's a lot of stuff to fill out.
It is, but that's your basics.
Awesome.
Yep, and so what we're gonna have now is it'll finalize settings and take us to the desktop. Once we get to the desktop, you wait for 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
5 minutes.
That's a long time.
It is.
What are we supposed to do in that amount of time? Cheers, darling.
Time's up.
Well, it's about time.
Yeah, I know, right? So now that we've waited for 5 minutes, we're going to shut the PC down.
Shut down, not restart.
Shut down, not restart.
All right, got it.
It's really important that we do it this way because it gives the PC time to install all of its drivers and complete all the processes so that the PC is set up all the way before we try to add stuff to that.
Okay, so don't install any devices until after the second boot, correct?
Correct. Because once we start installing things, like your printer, your scanner, things like that, we want to do it one component at a time so that we can make sure that that component, whether it's your printer, your scanner, your network, that it's working correctly.
So one at a time to make sure that they're all going to do what they need to do. Is there anything in particular that we should start off with first?
Absolutely. If you haven't connected your network, that's what you want to do. So if it's
cool.
Wireless, connect your wireless router. If it's wired, just plug the network cable in and you'll be up and going.
Awesome. And then can we install the printer?
That's when you can install the printer.
So I can write my first novel?
Absolutely.
Awesome.
So you can finally get all your peripherals installed. Again, you want to make sure that as you do that, each one doesn't have any issues.
Okay, so key for the day is to be patient.
Patience is a virtue.
Yes, it will all pay off in the long run.
Once you get all your peripherals installed and your software, then go ahead and change all the settings for your PC. You can change your desktop. You can add a screensaver.
Ooh, like
those
pictures?
Cool things. Yeah.
Awesome.
Absolutely. Yes.
Of my dog?
Of your dog.
Awesome.
Yes. And that's it. That's the best way to start your PC to get the most out of it.
And after setup, we recommend that you open HP Support Assistant and scan for any kind of updates. If you can't find HP Support Assistant on your computer, you can go to hp.com/go/HP Support Assistant to download. This is a great software program designed to keep your computer in working order and prevent any potential problems. It will also scan your PC and automatically detect and install the latest software and drivers available from HP. It will really help to keep your PC up to date after your initial setup. All right, thanks everyone. That's a wrap for this episode. You can follow us on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/howtoforyou, or check us out on the HP support forum at
hp.com/support forum.
Let us know what you want to hear about in our future episodes. And check out our next episode in 2 weeks, where Bill and I will be at the HP Social Care Global Meetup in San Francisco, bringing you some how-to tips and tricks directly from the experts of the HP Support Forum.
That's right. And a really big shout out to our HP experts. These are customers just like you across the globe, participating in our forums in 7 different languages. They're responsible for the majority of our answers on the HP support forums. They do a great job, and they're volunteers. It's awesome. They are just spectacularly awesome.
You
Big
guys
shout out to them.
Are so awesome.
Yep.
And we have actually enjoyed meeting all of you while we've been here in San Francisco, because through the magic of filmmaking...
We're in San Francisco right now!
Look! The Golden Gate Bridge!
It's awesome!
We're having a blast!
Way too much fun!
Bye!
See you next time! 'Round like a donut. There's a plug for you, Randy.
I'm not nice.
You're awesome.